At the Touchdown Club, where Carl Durrell was introduced as the 27th full-time head coach in Colorado football history. I thought he came off really well.
Yeah.
Comfortable in his own skin. Much different personality than Mel Tucker, though.
Yeah, I think he's going to be a little more soft-spoken, a little, Mel was interesting because sometimes he would have that bubbly, jokey personality, and then sometimes he would be, really subdued. I think Carl Durrell is going to be more of that subdued personality. I thought he came across and did a good job. I think there were certainly some questions that he was asked that he didn't quite know the answers to, which personally I expect after this process only started four days ago. So when he was asked about scheme, he didn't quite give maybe the answer fans want, but I didn't expect him to know that answer right away. So I thought he did a good job of kind of showing that, hey, I don't know that answer yet, but we'll get to it. I thought he did a good job. I thought he came across well, and it was a good first press conference.
He's very deliberate with his words, and you can tell that he wants to answer your question.
Yeah.
I think we're going to have a great relationship with him as media. Mm-hmm. Rick George and Lance Carl, they looked at some other guys. We know that. Rick George wasn't going to go on the record with us, and he didn't want to talk about that stuff. Mm-hmm. But it's just interesting how this kind of evolved with a guy that had a house here that when Rick and Lance first thought of him, they didn't even realize he had the house here.
Yeah, well, I think, as Rick wasn't going to tell us things, but we did learn through the press conference, and, Carl Durrell told the whole story. They didn't reach out to him until last Thursday. That was the ninth day of the process. So that's a clear indication that he was not their first choice. I doubt they started the search 9 days in. So I think that very clearly he was not the first choice, maybe not the second, third, or fourth. But, it's interesting that he didn't come to mind until Thursday. And the phone call was, hey, would you be interested in the job? And Carl's answer was, yeah, in fact, I'm flying to Colorado this weekend or tonight because my home is there and I'm spending time with the wife. So just kind of a unique set of circumstances there that it worked out. I don't know if you believe in fate or whatnot, but it certainly seemed like a fateful marriage for these guys.
In a glimpse into the type of guy that Carl Durrell is, he was asked, well, were you interested in this job? And he brought up his friend in Kansas City. We know who that is, Eric Bieniemy. Yeah. And he said he kind of wanted to take a step. He didn't want to interfere with the whole process, which that shows integrity.
Yeah, I thought so. I think, again, that was another thing that you probably learned out of this situation was that Eric Bieniemy was certainly a candidate. It wasn't just a name thrown out there that Carl Durrell said, hey, I knew that was a possibility. I wanted to step back from that. And so it was interesting. He had some honesty there, and I threw that out there, but I agree with you. It kind of shows his character that he didn't want to really get involved with that until he knew probably that Eric Bieniemy was not going to be a part of it.
And there's no doubt that he views this as a long-term deal. This is not a stepping stone for him at this stage of his coaching career, given how much he loves Colorado. I wonder how much that played into the thinking, because we know Rick and Lance, again, they didn't want to have to do this again 14 months again like they did this time.
Yeah, well, I think if it's true what we've heard, that Eric Bieniemy was the top target and they went after him, and then they went to Carl Durrell, it's clearly they're going after Buffs, guys that they think can be here for a while. Rick was asked, We talked to him separately, a few reporters, and he was asked, was there any thought to maybe going with Cheverini until November? And Rick said, absolutely not. I mean, just no knock on Chev, but it was more he didn't want to do this again. He wanted to do this right now and get it done and not have to do it for a while. He doesn't want to have to do this 2, 3, 5 years down the road. He'd love for Carl to be here for a long time.
And Steve Sarkisian, another name that, I feel pretty confidently that he was offered the job and was pretty close at one point to possibly taking it until Alabama steps up and keeps him. That would have been an interesting hire, but there's no guarantee he wouldn't have used CU as a stepping stone.
Yeah, and I think for me, I didn't think that was such a big deal. I think if CU is a stepping stone, I think that's fine, in my opinion. If Steve Sarkisian comes in here and in 3 years takes you a couple bowl games and moves on, great. The program's in a better spot. Move on as a stepping stone, then get somebody else in here. That was my opinion. Rick George, I think, wanted somebody that was going to be here longer. And Carl Durrell, unless he doesn't do well and gets fired, is going to be the head coach here for a long time.
And just going back to his personality, he seems like the type of person that will be able to keep these players here.
Yeah.
It's going to be some work with the 2020 signees, and a lot of that's determined on how he rounds out his staff here.
Yeah.
But I think this is a guy that can create some stability within this program. And these players, I mean, rightfully so, have been hurting here the last couple weeks.
Yeah, no question. And, you know, Tyler Lytle is a quarterback that has got a chance to win the starting job this year. You know, this is his third head coach, fourth offensive coordinator, and he'll have his fourth quarterback coach in 4 years on campus. So he's not the only one that's going through some instability like that. So they need a guy that's going to be here and, like you said, provide that stability. I think Carl's going to do that. Certainly he's got to get some coaches in here, but I think there's going to be some stableness to this program here.
$3.8 million assistant coaching pool.
Yeah.
It's challenging because of the timing, but that's quite a bit of money to be able to throw at some of these coaching candidates as he rounds out this staff.
Yeah, and we'll see how that plays out. You know, everybody wants to know what the staff is going to be right away. Yeah. I'm curious, you know, how many staffers will stay. We saw a few of them that showed up to the press conference, and at least in my mind, that's maybe a good sign that those guys are at least behind this a little bit. We saw Tyson Summers there. We saw Tavares Tillman there. So there was a couple guys who were here, and maybe that's a good sign that these guys want to stick around.
And not only running out the staff, reaching out to those 2020 signees, you got to get a jump start on 2021 recruiting. I know
Yeah. It's
10 months off until that early signing period, but The process is so accelerated that you've got to target and start getting these kids on campus really early on. And then spring ball is just around the corner. They got to figure out what kind of offensive system. It sounds like they're going to stick with a 3-4 defensively, but just so much work for him to, in these coming days.
Yeah, no question. The spring ball is supposed to start 3 weeks from today. We'll see. I know the spring game can't really change.
Yeah.
We'll see how that schedule tweaks, but they really have to start in about 3 weeks. So, you know, there's a lot of work to do. You got to come up with that system. You got to figure out the coaching staff. I would guess that the coaching staff is not fully in place, or at least they just got here by the time spring ball starts. So spring ball will be interesting, I think, but certainly recruiting is going to be interesting with him because he hasn't done it in so long, and it's different. I mean, he hasn't recruited since 2014 at Vanderbilt. As you know, recruiting is a lot different than 2014, certainly a lot different from 2007 when he was at UCLA. So he's got to figure that out, and he's a smart guy. I think he will.
Yeah, if he gets a staff with good recruiters, I can see his personality kind of being that closer in a father figure type way.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it really comes down to what the assistants are doing on the recruiting trail a lot of the times. Obviously, you want a head coach that can relate to recruits. That's obviously important as well.
But don't you think my thought with Darrell is he's going to be a guy that's going to relate well with the parents.
Absolutely.
And I think that's a big deal in recruiting. I don't know, not saying he won't relate well with recruits, but with the parents, I think he'll resonate there.
Yeah. How are you holding up? I was joking with my wife last night that if I never cover another coaching search, it will be too soon.
I totally agree with you. I'm kind of done with this, and you know, I didn't think we'd have to do this again, but yeah, it's exhausting. And even just things like, you know, I knew the announcement was going to come out yesterday, and you know, I cover the women's basketball team for the Daily Camera, and they had their biggest win in years yesterday, and I sort of feel bad for them because nobody paid attention to it because the coach became official. So kind of feel bad for them. And my attention kind of throughout that game was on Carl Durrell.
Yeah.
And so, you know, it's kind of sliding to some of those other programs. And the basketball team, the men's basketball team probably loves it because they had a bad loss, not a bad loss, but a disappointing loss against UCLA. But all the attention was on Carl Durrell that day. So, but yeah, it's exhausting. I'm a little ready to move on from this. I'm excited for when those 10 assistants get in place. And then we really won't have to worry about it anymore.
And then we'll actually get back to covering some football. That'll be nice. Spring ball, we don't know exactly when it's going to start. It was, like you said, scheduled for 3 weeks from today. We'll see. But we'll be back this spring with a lot of analysis videos. Appreciate you guys for tuning in.